Oh, right. We are not ready for your day, and I'm looking forward to casting this one for you. We are trying to go for a all-in 12-pop scout build. We have been relatively successful, and we're playing at about 1615 ELO. I know I brought you from the bringers of 8-pop scouts. Pooplord is back with a new and even crazier strat. This one has some advantages and some disadvantages over the 8-pop scouts. The reason that I went for 8-pop scouts is because Khmer don't require the additional building. Now, we have to overcome that in this strategy. The way that we're going to overcome that is we're actually going to go for slightly more villagers. And we're going to go for wood earlier than we normally would with Khmer. We're actually going to build a lumber camp as we do require buildings anyway, so we might as well get that lumbar camp. We really want to find our sheep here. We're getting food as quickly as we possibly can. Not sheep, sorry, deer. We want to find deer here. I've just lagged. Okay, yep, that's fine. Nice. Oh god. Please, PC, don't break on me. I really want to find my deer earlier rather than later. I've yet to have that luck, jury, of finding my deer early. Really, nowhere. Oh god, they're over there. Okay, go here, go there. Alright, everybody come in. Everybody come in. Why you no one to work? Okay, so here's the overcoming. Of the wood, we send free. We are going to idle because it's a Pooplord strat, so you have to idle your TC. Okay, and now we need one more. And we can actually pick up Loom, because Loom is nice. And in a bit, we'll talk about the downside and the upside to this. Because you'll see the Feudal Age, when we do hit it, we actually hit Feudal around the same time with slightly stronger economy and wood in the bank. But keeping the scouts flowing is going to be a bit trickier. Come around. We're just waiting for 175 wood. We're not making any additional doodaders. An ostrich has 140 food, so you actually need to push all three. This one does require a bit more effort than the 8-pop scouts. A lot of our food is being spent on additional villagers. And we are saving that rhino purposely. That is not a mistake. And one more. Yeah, that's good enough. Okay, there it is, the wood. Barracks. Back to wood. I'm bringing these sheep a little bit more. Now, this one might run out, so we're just going to safety sheep it here. Always have a safety sheep. Yeah, because look at this pushing. Trash. You're trash at this game, Poop. So we're going to look at the bar. It's 100 food in there. So when about 30% is gone. Wow. Up. Wood. Rhino. Wood, rhino. We can actually catch up to him once we get Feudal Age, so that's going to be great. We want to take advantage of that. Want to just wait till we're Feudal here, which is just about now. Now we can outrun. I go forwards. Make scouts. Bring one vill forwards as well. That will allow us to get a tower. So it's a little bit more difficult to keep this initial scout stuff going. No loom. That's a weak one. We're gonna get that weak one. Bye-bye. Drop off. Keep the scouters going. Force the house up. Switch to sheep. This is a table flipper moment if I've ever seen one. That's three vills down. Oh, he just deleted all his vills. Oh man, 12 pop scouts, baby. 12 pop scouts. I love that he just deleted everything at 1670 elo. I knew it. I knew this was the next 8 pop scouts to the next lever. I bring you 12 pop scouts. Oh baby, how sweet it is to be loved by you. I really want to capture age this one, just as like a little bonus. People say that they appreciate and like that. This will also allow me to go over the build slightly better here. Normally you have to place a tower and that works out very, very nicely. We start off with a total of 6 on food because food, as I mentioned before, is good. We want to find our rhino as well as our deer. We found our deer very, very late, which I hate for this strategy because you preferably want to push all 3 of them in before feudal age. That way you get the fastest feudal age possible. I wonder if we hit like a 730 is normally pretty standard for this one. Now, once we have those 6 onto food, we're going to go for 3 onto the wood stuff over here. This will allow us to get our second building. We're not going to go for a mill. If the game went longer than it did, we could actually transition with the 2 villagers that are on wood still to a mill, and that will give us continual food production. So it doesn't run out as fast as the 8 pop scouts. The problem is when you just go up to feudal, you sometimes have some food issues and you have to force drop off. Whereas with the commercial strategy, you don't have to do that at all. We found the deer, we're pushing the deer as we do. We're putting 2 additional onto food here. Now we have the 11 pop. We get the loom as well because that is swell. We idle a little bit RTC because, hey, that's just me. Poop nation material I am. Barracks now because we have the wood. Try to push in the last deer. Then once we click up, we're going to move some of these villagaries over to the wood. Sadly, my 3rd ostrich isn't in normally. This would be an ostrich. So always have a safety sheep ready. Spaghetti, to hop on it. It has now been reached. We push this in. We saw the scout, actually, from what I remember. So keep this in mind. You're going to be up faster than they are. So if you can snipe their scout, that is very, very favorable. Bring in the elefante. We have enough wood with the three that are over here to create a stable right at the beginning. We're just matching up over here, making sure that he's not going to try and get a cheeky bonus on us, and we clear that up without too many problems. He hasn't picked up loom, but he has clicked up. We're getting scouts already, and now we have 1 minute to do as much damage as we possibly can. We're going to send one villager forward. We will eventually have the wood for a tower, and now we're just looking over here. We saw that weak one. We snipe that one, no pro blamo. Oh, so much fun. And now you just have to get value out of your scouts. You really have to kill two to three villagers or have him tilt from this. Yeah, so that's unfortunate, but we did get a whole bunch of them over there. He now goes feudal. He doesn't have loom, so we keep sniping additional ones. I was like, I really want to put this on the gold. That way it stops archers. I didn't scout enough his base because the deer were a little bit slow. Normally, he would scout a little bit better. I think over here would have been the best place for the tower if I had done proper scouting. Or over here, you can protect the tower with a whole bunch of scouts, which is absolutely as well. Let's quickly look at these statistics just because I want to see how fast the feudal age time actually was. 5-1. I thought it was 3-0, but that was the previous one that we won this with. Whew. I don't care about any of this. I want to see resources collected. There we go. You can see that he has significantly more resources, but we don't care. 7-13. Wow, that is very quick. When I was testing it out, it was about a 7:30 or something in that nature. And with that, don't let your memes just be dreams. Keep on walking. I hope you enjoyed this strategy and this cast. Nuts. Absolutely nuts strategy. This one's so fun. I'm so happy I made this one work. I can't believe you guys were right. You said better than APOP scouts. I believe it is. It has some drawbacks, but I believe overall the advantages outweigh the drawbacks because we can now actually move over to, for example, onto berries over here because of the wood that we have collected for a mill. Chill. What a game. What a game.